Welcome to Oxford Instruments video guide to the Optista Dry. How to set up your system. If you are setting up the system yourself, make sure you have read the system manual and other relevant material. You must understand all of the health and safety information before you start to set up your system. If you have paid for an Oxford Instruments engineer to install your system, we will do all of this section for you. Assuming you have purchased a stand, you must adjust the cryostat and fit the radial restraints. To ensure the vertical alignment of the cryostat, you will need to make small adjustments to the M6 nuts and anti-vibration mounts. Refer to the system manual for full details. To make minor adjustments to the optical beam height, release the top M6 nuts on all four anti-vibration mounts. Using a laboratory jack, leave the cryostat to the desired height. Make sure that the jack does not come in direct contact with the OVC window blank on the base of the cryostat. When you get to the correct height, adjust all four lower M6 nuts so they touch the bottom of the L brackets. Lower the laboratory jack and remove it. When you do this, the vibration mounts will compress by a small amount. You may need to repeat this process to get the exact height you need. When you are happy with the cryostat height, tighten the M6 bolts using the spanners from the optional spares kit. In the toolbox, you will find the four radial restraints. Fit the radial restraints between the cryostat and the locator blocks on the stand legs. Insert an Allen key in the through hole and lengthen the radial restraints using your fingers. You may need to adjust the height of the locator block to ensure the radial restraints is horizontal. When the block is in the correct position, tighten the screws. Repeat this operation for all four radial restraints. When all four are in position, fix the final length of the radial restraints. Do not overextend them. The elastomer in each constraint should be only slightly compressed. There are two different types of compressor, air-cooled and water-cooled. This video focuses on the water-cooled version. The manual for the compressor is in box 2. You must read the manual and other relevant material. You must understand all of the health and safety information before you start to unpack the compressor. Remove the compressor from its packaging. Check the static pressure to ensure it has not lost any helium gas. Remove the shipping bolt as described in the manual. Check the tip and tail indicators fitted to the compressor. If any of these have been activated, please let us know. You must provide suitable cooling water for the compressor. Make the water fittings at the compressor. Ensure you use two spanners to tighten the fittings. Start the water flow and make sure you have no leaks. You must provide suitable electrical power for your compressor. Please make sure you understand all the health and safety requirements before you do this. Turn the compressor before you fit the helium lines. Carry out the SHI procedure to check the operation of the compressor. Once this test is complete, unpack the helium lines and fit the labels to them. Remove the caps and fit the lines to the compressor. Ensure you use two spanners to tighten the fittings. Fit the helium lines to the cold head. Again, ensure you use both spanners to tighten them correctly. Make sure you connect the supply to the supply and the return to the return. Connect the cold head power cable to the cold head and to the compressor. Connect the cryostat cable to the back of the Mercury ITC, making sure to do up the retaining bolts. Connect the other end to the 15-way micro D connector on the cryostat. Again, tighten the retaining bolts to ensure good electrical connection. If you want any more information, see our Optista Drive videos or visit our website.